Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. I'm gonna show you the newly designed Google Assistant app today. I'm gonna run you through all the features, all the new features, and all of the new ways to navigate this app, and therefore then apply all of the new great home automation features to your life. The new Google Assistant app has been completely redesigned. Let's get right into it. Right away, you can see the differential here. Up at the top, right away, right off the bat, you can see it's good morning. It's actually recognizing that it's morning here, and it's recognizing the weather that's right up at the top. Now, on top of that, you can see down below that is the travel time to work. It kind of knows this is the time, or a little before this, I go to work. And then there's a set of basic things that you might want to do every day. You can kind of scroll through that and then explore what's new. There's your calendar. You could add a reminder, add an event if you had any there. I'll show you in a bit what it looks like. Here's your stocks. If you click the three dots, you can edit them. And there's more exploring you can do as you get kind of further down the application. Now, up at the top right, there's some buttons you can see, and still at the bottom, there's the Google Assistant where you could actually go and talk or speak right to your Google Assistant. Now, once I refresh the page, notice that the travel or the map disappears. If you exit and re-enter the app, that comes back, but it's gone for right now. So they kind of show you that if you don't want to use it, then obviously you're not going anywhere. Now, up at the top right, the very top right icon, this will look familiar to you. It's kind of taking you to the Explore section of the Google Assistant application. Up at the top right, if you tap on the three dots, there's your account, your settings, your Google app settings, all kinds of different things that you can do. I'm not going to run through that just yet. Now, if I tap at the bottom where you see the icon for the Google Assistant, it takes you back to that home page. You can see the navigation now is very quick between the two. So I'm going to throw out the Assistant app just to show you how it comes back. Again, there's the traffic. It shows up, but if I was to refresh, it goes away. Now, top right again, you see this new icon. I don't know what to describe it as other than kind of a folded in box. It looks like it's opening up. I don't know what they're depicting there. Someone will tell me, I'm sure, in the comments. But when you tap that, this is the interface you get. They're giving you some of those daily things that you might do. It's basically a quick jump to the Google Assistant, and you can just tap on some of these things. So there's my daily brief. You can see they're telling me the weather, what's going on, my trip to work. And that daily brief is set in your Google Home application, and then in the settings for your Google Assistant, you can actually set up what you want your day to do. I can go ahead and make a call. I can choose a contact, and then it will allow me to make that phone call right from the application here. I can also send a message if I'd like. And I didn't love the interface here, but you can type in your message, choose your contact, and then it actually takes you over to the messaging app in your phone. So in the iPhone, that's messaging. So like I said, there you go. The message gets sent off, and it's very simple. Now, the one thing I'll say here is, now that I've done a couple of things in Google Assistant, I don't actually have those quick items. I'd have to actually start speaking to my Google Assistant instead, using that little microphone link in the bottom right. So you lose those quick actions, but you could go there and back and forward a couple of times if you wanted. So now back to the main page. I'm going to add a reminder. I'm going to show you how easy this workflow is. So I just tapped on add a reminder, and here it comes up. You can type it in. I'm going to say check the weather, and I'm going to set that for 1, and you'll see the differential on the main page here once it's added. So I've added that in, and here's the main page. You can see it's added that reminder. In the stock world, this is kind of interesting. You can go ahead, edit stocks, and all you have to do is search for the stock you want to in the top of this interface. Once you find that stock, you're just going to tap on the star in the top right of that. And once you do that, you can hit done and go back to the Google Assistant application and it will add it. So very easy interface for adding in stocks and changing what you want to pay attention to. This will also change the stocks that you see on all of Google services. So this is all tied together now. Now moving down the application, we could explore using the assistant. So I'm going to tap on local. You can tap on any of these little applications that are part of the Google Assistant app. So very quick interactions with this application now, whereas in the past, what I would say is it could take you a long time if the Google Assistant didn't get you straight to the right response. But now with this new interface, it's a lot easier to go back and forth and find the information you need using both the Google Assistant itself or just this interface on your phone or your tablet. Now, up at the top, I want to show you the play music button just to show you a couple of these buttons. I'm going to hit play music. You can see it skips over to the actual Google Assistant. And for me, I had defaulted Apple Music and I'm not going to play any music from that, but we can also go ahead and hit play news. It will preload one of your news sources or your first news source, and then you could skip ahead. You could play that news source. You've got lots of options there as well. And again, all of those are set up in your settings as part of the My Day section. You can also tap on the What's on My Shopping List, and that brings up your shopping list that you've already set up. If you have a Google Home or you've just been using the Google Assistant, you can see you can manage that there. So again, a very quick back and forth between the two. Now, I'm going to show you on an iPhone what the interface looks like from the widget screen here. You can see I have the Google Media controls and I also have the Google Assistant. That portion of the application has not yet changed. It's just a button to simply tap to talk to your Google Assistant. And all it does is it brings up the page where you're talking to the Google Assistant. And you can see it goes straight into listening, not to the main page. Now I'm going to show you how to manage your settings in the application, or the quickest way to get there that I've found so far. Up in the top right, there's the Explore icon. Go ahead, tap on that. And then top right again, the three dots takes you to the menu for all the different settings within the application. I'm just going to tap on settings, and then here you go. These are all the Google Assistant and your Google Home settings. You can change your music provider, which you saw I had Apple Music before, and I've changed to Google Music. So I think that's a pretty good breakdown of the new Google Assistant app. And I would say that Google has actually created a lot of automation, or a lot of quicker interaction with the Google Assistant and with even the home control in your home, because you can ask Google Assistant to do all of that, and it's very quick navigation. So I'm really impressed with this update from Google on the Google Assistant app.